Okay, so this will be a short video, and this will just be a sort of follow-up and added business topics. Okay, added business topics to the previous business. What to prepare before you open up a business. Okay, so this will sort of be a part two. Okay, maybe a part two. I'll make the title later. Okay. So, first, an update. I'll bring you back to the first example I made on the previous video. I'll put that video below on the previous video. So, this is an update on the previous video. What's the latest on that previous video, okay? I'll write that down, the title of the previous video. Okay, so update. This is an update. UPDATE update. So, the one that I told you, the one with the company, with on the first around 3 weeks maybe or less, 3 weeks. Opening day of the company. The company was literally filled to the rafters. Filled to the rafters. The seating was already outside the room. You have to wait outside the room to eat. Okay, to eat. Outside the room to eat. And luckily, I had the last seat inside. I don't have to wait outside. I had the last one seat inside. So I sat there. And I observed. It was really filled, totally filled. Nowhere to move, nowhere. Totally filled. Opening day. First 3 weeks maybe of opening day. First 3 weeks or less of opening day. Like what I told you, I just make a recap of what I told you before, and so logically, for example, let's make a number. So just take, for example, only. This is an example only. Not the real people, number of people eating there, okay? So, let's make it 100. 100 people were eating, filled to the rafters, waiting outside the room already. Those coming in. The outside was, you really like to eat there. Sorry for that. I have a cough now. COUGH. Cough. So, outside, you really would like to eat there. Great facade. If you read the menu, it was so enticing. So enticing. I think they made a survey of what everybody liked. Okay, what type of foods, in quotation marks. What type of foods everybody liked. It was carefully planned. Okay? So you really would go inside, literally go inside, and like to eat. Because of the menu and facade. Okay? But the hitch there is me, I waited less than 2 hours. Probably for other more rich, R-I-C-H, rich looking dignitary. Probably the wait was only 30 minutes. Okay, 30 minutes or more. Okay? I had to wait less than 2 hours. Okay? I was not dressed like a rich person. Okay? Not dressed like a rich person. I was too tired, dead tired at that time. Too tired, dead tired. D-E-A-D. Dead tired. So probably if they want to sacrifice one person, they sacrificed me and made me wait less than 2 hours. So counting that factor in, that waiting time, more than 30 minutes, multiplied. For every first customer, they also experienced that. Less than 2 hours, more than 30 minutes, waiting time for your food. Because like I said, the company wasn't prepared to feed those large number of people. Okay, sorry for the cough. Now, update. It's still like what I told you before. The tons of people who went in there and ate for the first time never came back. Never came back. That's an update up to now. 11:45 up to 1 o'clock, peak season, peak time to eat. No one is eating. No one is eating. You could play their ping pong. No one is eating. It's still up to now. That's an update. So what's the moral of the story? If 100,000 people came, 100,000 never came back. Never, not one of them. One chance only, they will never come back. All those people who waited will never come back. That's the reason why no one's eating there now. Okay? So it is a different topic. Okay, close that. It is a different topic. And now I'm telling a story about a company. Normally, sorry for the cough. Company normally filled. Normally filled. The whole day. The company has no lag time. No lag time of if you are eating, no lag time. The company is totally, the whole day, from opening to closing, the whole day, moderately filled, consistently. If not, totally filled. Okay? Sorry for the cough. Very itchy. Okay? The company is normally moderately filled. Notice the term moderate. Notice that I never used minimally filled. Okay? Minimal, no. It was always moderately filled the whole day. Opening to closing. That's to say the least. To say the least. Okay? Moderately filled. But unfortunately, that was long ago. Okay? That was long ago. So why the change? Why the change? Why now are there people not anymore eating that much on that company? What caused the people to move out of that company and not return? Return to it. Okay? I'll give you probably 2 reasons. 2 reasons probably. So businessmen out there, listen. This might be some of the reasons. There will be less and less, less and less, less and less returning customers, okay? Totally ichikaw. Sorry. So here are the two reasons why probably previously the minimum you have eating there are moderately filled the whole day. Minimally, okay? So that could go off to with the waiting line, okay? That was previously. So what are the two reasons that could be the reason why fewer people are eating there at your, in quotation marks, peak time? Okay? This is a new, another company. One reason I noticed I don't know if it was the management decision, I don't know. Management decision, or probably the rank and file employees decision. Okay? I noticed that if you have a change, 95 centavos and lower, 95 cents and lower, Philippine peso, Philippine denomination, lower than 95 centavos, I noticed that they never give you that change. I noticed that. And probably, for example only, in my 20 times there, for every 20 times there, they gave me 1 to 2 pesos less as a change for every 20 times I ate there. Okay, so that's only probably a random happening. But I noticed they don't give the change due to you. Okay? Now, thinking logically, for every business, the price for every product, service, there is already an input there for earnings. Okay? No matter what you do, no matter what you think, they will earn and they will earn. That company will earn money. No matter how hard you think, the company will earn money. Okay? It's already built into their prices. Okay? That's for all businesses and for all companies. Okay? Now, considering that fact, okay, built in, so there's already a profit margin. Okay? So, why take the 95 centavos? That's only, we call that small change. Why keep that and be numb? NUMB, numb. Numb and be silent about it. In Tagalog, we call that, bakit yung nagsusukle, dead ma? The one who gives you the change is totally silent that the change is lacking in 95 centavos or less. Okay, that may be from 5 centavos to 95 centavos. Okay? They don't give you the change. Centavos, okay? So, what's my point here? What's my point? It's only a small, we call that paltry sum of money, okay? Everybody agrees on that. But, what we call that, in Tagalog, kailangan may prinsipyo ka rin. No? It's not the money. In Tagalog, we call that prinsipyo. Prinsipyo ka. May tubo ka na eh. Diba? Bakit po baka nga rin yung barya? I hope you got my point, no? You have already profit earnings. Why still get the 95 centavos, the 5 centavos to 95, 95 centavos to 5 centavos? Range. R-A-N-G-E. Range of change that you never give. So again, 1 in 30 times I went there, 1 in 40 times I went there, it was more than 1 peso, lacking in change. Okay? And we call that prinsipyo, no? In Tagalog, prinsipyo. Asa na prinsipyo nung kumpanya, di ba? I think many have already told the upper management about that, but probably upper management don't care because of the billions they earn. Okay? It's actually no problem to them. Okay, if you lose one customer, what is one customer to you? Okay, that's really true. Okay? One customer is complaining for paltry sum of change. Let that customer go away. Okay? I hope you got my point. Now, so, that's one reason. Okay? Maybe management knows, upper management, or maybe it's only by the rank and file and it doesn't reach the level of the management that something's happening there. 5 centavos to 95 centavos are not being returned to the customers, even though it's a paltry sum. Okay? Again, we call that in Filipino, Tagalog, prinsipyo naman, no? Kailangan may prinsipyo ka rin eh. Yung kumpanya mo may prinsipyo. Or, you have to hire employees, rank and file, or probably contractuals, to say the least, who have prinsipyo and not get the money for themselves. You have to hire individuals with prinsipyo and not the ones who want to get small sums of money, small change. I hope you got my point, okay? That's in the hiring process. Okay? It's minor, it's nothing. But in Tagalog, we call that prinsipyo. Kailangan may prinsipyo ka rin. Principles in life, your value system. Okay? You value the other people's centavos change. Okay? So, here is probably another reason. Reason number two. The advertisement was showing a six lab, SLAB. Wow! Six lab. T-H-I-C-K, six lab, SLAB. Wow! Sorry for that. Six lab SLAB. Wow, I like to buy that. It's so thick. Full of wood like that. And it costs so much less and so cheap. CHEAP. It costs less money. And the picture is full of wood inside. I like to buy that. Okay, so then you buy, it's your first time. Remember, this is reason number two for why the previously moderately full company long ago, as in unimaginable long ago, is now getting less than minimal occupancy. People eating there are less than minimal eating there the whole day, less than minimal. It never gets filled up, never. Whenever I pass there, there's only one or two. Sometimes it's black, no one's eating. I hope you got my point, okay? So I like to buy. So cheap, so low priced. So take out. And then, at home while I was eating the food, it's hard to describe. Probably the English word there is, I was taken aback. Taken aback. Taken aback. Aback. Probably that's the proper word. I can't believe what I saw and holding in my hand the food. I said to myself, where's the thick slab, S-L-A-B? Thick slab of food inside. It's full of air and there's no meat inside. So now it got me thinking, why are the pictures having thick slabs, SLABS, of meat inside, but when you bought it and took it home, there's air only inside, and not that much meat, M-E-A-T. So, think about it. The owners out there who own businesses, the moral lesson is here is, don't make advertisements with pictures and promote the product. But in Tagalog, we call that yung picture mo, kapal ka pa nung karne, pero dinadaya mo yung mamimili. Hangin lang pagdating sa kanya. Asan yung picture? Nakuha nyo? Yun ang tanong ng mamimili. Asan yung picture? Dapat nagtala ako rito ng picture. Iba. Iba doon sa picture. Ang layo. Ang layo sa picture. Therefore, yung small price nila, nakala mong namurahan ka, wala naman palang laman. We call that in Tagalog, tubulugaw sila talaga. Ngayon, pag in-analyze mo, mahal pala ng binayad mo sa totoo lang. Although, when you saw the picture, you thought that you were earning money because the product is so cheap, low priced. Ikaw pala yung nalugi. Okay? Nalugi and ano kaya, ang tawag natin doon sa Tagalog. Ikaw yung nabudol. B-U-D-O-L. Nabudol. Nabudol ka ng picture. Ang kapal ng picture, pero nung inuwi mo na, hangin lang ang laman. Asan yung karni sa loob? Di ba? Asan? Where's the meat inside? There's only air inside. And you bought air. So in short, you were 1, 2, 3 like that. 1, 2, 3. You were scammed. Okay, that's a, for lack of a better term, you were scammed. S-C-A-M-M-E-E-D. S-C-A-M-M-E-D. S-C-A-M-M-E-D. You were scammed. Okay? Scammed into believing and being fooled into believing that you bought a nice price full of meat item. Okay? So, those are the two reasons. Now, think of it. Everybody listening there, think of it. If the change and the fake photos, that's a fake photo actually. Okay, it's not the product. Okay, you were fooled by a fake photo and you bought the product and you were scammed, S-A-M-M-E-D, scammed, plus the topic, the poultry change, okay? Those two factors, those two things, happening at the same time, I think you would 4 times, 6 times never go back to that place again. You would 4 times, 6 times never go back to that place again. Never eat at that place again. Okay? So those are the two reasons why some businesses, fully packed, moderately packed the whole day, are now minimally occupied. There are times when I pass by there at the food. There are times no one is eating. No one is eating. The place is blank. I thought that the place is under renovation. No one is eating. If you look out there, the cashiers are not in front. Okay? No one is in front. Okay? No cashier, no one's in front. No front desk, no one is there. Where are everybody? And you will think that it's under renovation. That's how zero the people going there are now. Now. Because of probably those factors and other factors that I haven't yet seen. Okay? So, in Tagalog, yung mga may-ari, SF-SF. No? Baka yung manggagawa nyo, may ginagawa mga naibubulsang barya, no? Tapos, we call that routine advertising. Okay? I think, as owners, we must not promote our products to be having thick meat, but when you sell it, it's totally meatless. Okay? I think there should be quality control in your kitchen. Probably, employees are eating your food. I hope you got my point. Employees are eating your food, and when you audit the store, it's all good. Why? Because all the meat are not being brought to the takeout people, the ones who buy takeout. They're given less. I hope you got my point. Probably that's the one happening. I don't know. Okay? Or probably, there's no truth in your advertising. Okay? It's some of those things. It's one of those things or both. Okay? So, as long as subscribe and follow and subscribe.